So post-traumatic stress disorder is typically found in about 1 in 10 Americans over their lifetime. When people have been exposed to combat or war, the prevalence is about twice that. It depends a lot on the experience that people have had with war. So the best evidence we have from Iraq and Afghanistan suggests that about 1 in 5 of service members who are returning have had post-traumatic stress disorder at some point in their lifetime. We just published this Institute of Medicine report that really is a synthesis of what we know about the treatment of PTSD in the Department of Defense and in the Veterans Administration. So the report identified several shortcomings in how we currently provide treatment for veterans and active duty military in DoD and VA. First of all, probably the biggest challenge is coordination and integration of services. There are really hundreds of programs in DoD and VA that all try to do their best to address PTSD in DoD and VA, and there is no real integration across them, and there is no real system for a service member to know that she or he is accessing the best possible care. There are also barriers that individual soldiers face. There are barriers that they face in coming forward with symptoms because they might be worried that they would have a diagnosis. They have barriers to accessing programs, particularly in some bases, particularly among soldiers who are not living close to health services. One of the phenomena that we saw with the Operation Iraqi Freedom, Operation Enduring Freedom, is the greater reliance on reserve forces for combat operations. These were reserve forces that were typically deployed for natural disasters, cleanup after Hurricane Katrina, who now were in combat. The problem is that many of these reserve forces do not have access to VA services the way many of the other regular duty military members have. And they are also spread out geographically. So you have service members or ex-service members in rural areas where there are no services anywhere for hundreds of miles around. And this is a big challenge, and it's a challenge that has no real easy solution. There has been discussion, and the report mentions this, of using more telemedicine and using more innovative ways to reach people who are really far away from services. And I think it is a challenge that the military broadly will be grappling with in the coming years. I think the good news is that there is tremendous willingness at the highest levels in DoD and VA to provide the best possible care for PTSD for service members. The Department of Defense and Veterans Administration are running these large complex systems, and it is hard to get complex systems to adapt to introduce new innovative programs and to do it with fidelity to the evidence. And I have deep respect for the efforts of the people who are trying to do that. There is no question that we are going to have, as a country, an influx of veterans, and a proportion of them, a substantial proportion, will have health needs, be they mental health needs or physical health needs. And I think the systems need to scale up. I think VA is scaling up, and there are other systems outside of VA, things like TRICARE, that are also scaling up. I think a equally interesting question is our societal scale up and how we deal with an influx of young men and women, principally men, who are eager to reintegrate in society and who have had this extraordinary, in many respects, very difficult experience overseas. And speaking from a university standpoint, I think a number of them will want to go to university, and creating these welcoming spaces in our society for these service members is going to be, I think, critical.